Hello, my name is Nevon Mansour and I work as application engineer at Vaisala. In this video, I will demonstrate how to do on-site calibration of CO2 in working incubator. It's good to remember that even the best high-performance measurement instruments require regular calibration and maintenance to ensure that they are working and providing the most accurate data possible. There are two ways of doing the on-site calibration. So the first one is to use our Indigo 80 handheld and GMP 251 CO2 probe with a flat cable. And the second one is to use Indigo 80 with our GMP 80P pump. The first way to do an on-site calibration of CO2 in a working incubator is to use the Indigo 80 handheld and the GMP 251 CO2 probe with the flat cable. Make sure that the GMP 251 probe connected to the Indigo 80 corresponds to the incubator measurement range and is freshly calibrated. Also, use a flat cable between the GMP 251 probe and the Indigo 80 handheld. Let's insert the GMP 251 probe into the incubator. By using a flat cable, you can close the door tightly. Let's set the environmental settings correctly. Temperature and relative humidity should correspond to the incubator temperature and relative humidity. The pressure can be set also if it differs significantly from the default 1013 HPA. Lastly, let's change the temperature compensation mode to set point. Now let's wait for the readings of the handheld device to be stabilized. This may take up to 10 minutes. After this, let's compare the readings of the freshly calibrated probe and the incubator CO2 reading. CO2 value of the incubator should be adjusted accordingly to the handheld reference instrument through the incubator user interface. Now the calibration is completed successfully. Another way of calibrating on-site is with the help of the GMP 80P pump and Indigo 80 handheld. First, you need to collect a sample. It's convenient to take a sample using Indigo 80 handheld and GMP 80P pump, as the sample can be taken through a sampling port. Also, keeping the calibrator door closed speeds up the calibration. So there are three different sampling options. First one is to use a steel pipe, second one is to use plastic tube, and the third one is to use Naphion tube combined with plastic tube. In this video, I will show how to do it with the Naphion tube combined with the plastic tube. First, we need to adjust environmental settings based on the sampling method. Relative humidity set point depends on what sampling method you are using. For steel pipe, it's 97%, for plastic tube is 90%, and for Naphion tube combined with the plastic tube, relative humidity value of ambient air in the location where your GMP 80P is located. And next, let's change the temperature compensation mode to measured. In this video, I will show how to do sampling with the Naphion tube combined with the plastic tube. Instructions for other sampling methods, please refer to GMP 80P pump user guide. Now, let's insert the end of the Naphion tubing into the incubator. Sampling will start automatically when GMP 80P pump is connected to Indigo 80 handheld. Sampling the hot and humid air from the incubator causes condensation, which will increase CO2 concentration on the GMP 80P. The sample can be dried with the optional Naphion tubing. The measurement error can be solved by using the coefficients from the user guide of the GMP 80P pump. So when we have the CO2 measurement value shown by Indigo 80, you can use the coefficients given in the table to calculate the actual gas concentration in the sampling environment. We can use the Vaisala humidity calculator to determine the dew point temperature of your sampling environment when you know its temperature and relative humidity values. We can see that when temperature is 37 Celsius and relative humidity 90%, the dew point temperature is 35 Celsius. Now from the table, we can see that the coefficients is 0.955. Next, we need to multiply this with the CO2 reading shown in the indicator to get the actual CO2 concentration at the sampling environment. If the readings don't match, you should adjust the incubator according to the manufacturer's instructions. Now the calibration is completed successfully. I hope this video was useful for you. Remember that Vaisala is your calibration expert. Please contact us for calibration services at vaisala.com.